There we go. Can you tell me your name?
My name is Jamila Yafit Biso.
And where do you work? What is your work?
I work in Acre as a field worker and public relation with people.
Can you tell me a little bit about what your work is with Acre? Maybe explain what Acre stands for.
Acre stands for the human right. Mm-hmm. Of human right of all the Palestinians to reach the land and, you know, the freedom of reach your own properties.
Yes.
And reach your land and the freedom of movement.
And it's an Israeli organization.
It's an Israeli rights. Organization. Yes, it's civil right. Yes. It's civil right. I don't know what to say.
Yes.
It's Acre, yes.
Yes.
Yes, but you know, I am
Association
so new
for Civil Rights in Israel.
Yes, okay. I'm new in this work, in this position, mm-hmm. and behind me something like 16 years on the field, mm-hmm. worker, you know, as a volunteer, as an activist, under the, you know, into the land of the Palestinians, the village, mm-hmm. and 3 years ago, I set up my own NGO. It's called Humans Without Borders. Humans Without Borders actually is a volunteer NGO. I have a group of volunteers who provide medical transportation for the sick, Palestinian sick. Most of them is children and adult also. My volunteer picks them up from the checkpoint to the Israeli hospital and accompanying him during the medical treatment and drive them back home safely and without any problem.
Can you tell me why this is so important to provide transportation?
It's important for two reasons. The first and most important reason is because the Israeli army the permit to accompany these sick children for the mother or the grandmother, and both of them, even the mother, neither the grandmother don't know any Hebrew word, and when they even they take a taxi, it's which is very very expensive for them, they will get lost into the hospital. This is most reason, and they cannot know which department and when they need to go. So my volunteer escort him and go with him to the department and take care of them. Mm. Now the second issue in when a Palestinian sick came to have a surgery into the hospital, they are not allowed to get out from the hospital. The permit is just for the hospital. They cannot get out from the hospital. Even if they stay 2 months, 3 months, they stay into the hospital.
So they can't see
their
family?
Yes, they can't see anyone. Mm-hmm. So my volunteer came here and, provide all they need. If they need food or, changes or
clothing,
everything. Yes. Everything. Mm. And most of our visit is, you know, for a little bit company and for let them, you know, feel not so stranger here. Mm. And they give them, you know, the sense of you have someone you can call him in the middle of night if you need something. Mm. You are not alone. This is the message. You are not alone here in Israel.
Can you tell me a little bit about your personal history, where you're from, and how and why you do this work?
You know, I was born in Damascus as an Arab Jewish, and I grew up with Palestinian kids. And I hear the story of the Palestinian from the old woman, all the stories about 48 and before 48 and after 48 and... You know, from like most of the Jewish family in Arab countries, they want a better future for their children, and they bring my children and they come here to Israel. You know, we south all that. You know, in these years on 85, I moved here on 85, and they told me my grandfather and all they told me that here, you know, this is Israel, it's Eretz Chalav Zavad Udvash, you know, is
a land flowing with milk and honey.
Yes, it's the land of the Jewish, and we should, all of us came. So, you know, I make a mix between the Jewish and, you know, between the stories that I am hearing from the Palestinian old women and from Palestinian friends.
So this motivates you to do your work.
Yes, so I from the beginning when I came here to Israel, you know, first of all, you know, the few first years, you know, I just arranged myself because I was a single mother with a kid. And the Syrian government punished me because I want to go to Israel, and they don't allow me to take with me my son. So I fight 2 long years for have my son here with me in Israel. Mm. And when I get my son, you know, I move to another fight to have my divorce from my husband who's still in Syria. So first 7 years, I just fight. Fighting for myself and for my family, and after the first seven years, I start this work. But from the beginning, when I came here to Israel, I keep relationship with Arab country. My kids start the first school here in Israel. It was an Arab school. I take them to Jaffa to some Arabic school because they don't want to study in Hebrew school. And they keep, you know, I keep relationship with Palestinian. I have friends from all over the West Bank and Gaza Strip. But you know, from the second Intifada, I still have a friend. But on the second Intifada, when the second Intifada start, it was, you know, a very, very big issue that can, you know, just, you know, give you a box in your eyes. I told you, wake up, you are not here in Honeyland, milk and honey land. You should just get out and help. And I start my movement. I start help the Palestinians, my friend, you know, who need to come to the hospital. And after the hospital and medical issue, it's beginning the harvest issue and the land right issue, and
it's grows.
Complicated. Yes, you are just blow up into this, you know, into this system, and you cannot get out because people call you and need help, and you cannot stay, you know, just outside. I told them I cannot.
Thank you, Jamila. Jamila works with ACRI, which is a partner of Rabbis for Human Rights.
Yes.
Thank you.